This lab activity is part of a three-part series. In this scenario, you are using GIS to help you plan a music festival. In part one, you will download data from public sources to get started. In part two, you will use the data to conduct a site suitability analysis to narrow down potential locations to hold the music festival. In part three, you will determine the event capacity based on several factors. This demo relates to the GSP 270 lab activity, Music Festival Part 1, Acquiring Data. The purpose of this activity is to review how to acquire data from public sources. The instructions are located on the Humboldt State Geospatial online website. I'll post a link to the instructions in the video description. The first step in any of these lab activities is to create a basic folder structure. Typically, this will be placed on your local hard drive. On a personal computer, this would be the C drive. If you are in one of the labs at Humboldt State, then it will most likely be the D drive. In this example, I am using the downloads folder located on my local C drive. I'll start by creating a top-level folder, which should indicate the lab assignment. Within this folder, I will create three subfolders: original, working, and final. Now I'm ready to download the data. Open your web browser and navigate to google.com. Enter the keywords Humboldt County GIS Data Download. Click the link for the official Humboldt County GIS download page. Take a moment to read the disclaimer and other metadata information, such as the data projection information. If you'll notice, it says that most of the Humboldt County GIS data is in the State Plane Spatial Reference System, specifically California State Plane Zone 1, NAD 27, and the units are in feet. For this project, you will be required to use the UTM Spatial Reference System. So even before you download the data, you should already know that you will eventually have to use a project tool to make new copies of the data in UTM. You will download four shapefiles from this website: a parcel layer, a county zoning layer, a roads layer, and a county boundary layer. Two of these layers are located near the top under Frequently Requested Datasets. Right-click on the Parcels Shapefile link. Select Save Link As, then navigate to your Originals folder. Save the compressed file inside your Originals folder. When it is done downloading, repeat these steps for the Roadway Centerline shapefile. Scroll down until you see Administrative Boundaries. Under Humboldt County Boundary, download the Humboldt County shapefile and save it to your original folder. Scroll down under Land Use, download the zoning shapefile and save it to your original folder. You now have the four datasets you need from this website. Open your original folder. You will see the shapefiles saved as compressed zip files. Right-click on each zip file, select 7-zip, then Extract Here. When you are done decompressing each shapefile, you won't need the original zip files. Be sure to delete them. It saves space and prevents confusion later on. In ArcMap, open a blank map document. The easiest way to add data is to use the catalog window. You'll typically see the catalog window pinned to the right side of the screen. Just click the button with the yellow file cabinet icon. When you first open the catalog window, you may not see your project folder right away. If you don't see it, you can add it using the Connect to Folder button. In this example, I'm going to connect to the Downloads folder so that it will appear in the catalog tree. Now I can access anything in the Downloads folder right from the catalog window. So what you will want to do next is click on the plus sign next to the Downloads folder to expand the tree. Navigate to the original folder and just drag and drop each shapefile onto the blank map document. If you will recall, the shapefiles have a green square icon. I'll start with a county outline shapefile, then the parcels, the roads, and the zoning shapefile. There are other files included in the data, but you will only need the shapefiles for now. Back on the Humboldt State Geospatial online website, scroll down to step 9. Use the link to save a copy of the QAQC form. I went over how to fill out a QAQC form in the previous demo called Issues with Projections. Review that demo for more information about QAQC forms. Normally, you would fill out a QAQC form for each of the layers. For this assignment, practice filling out a QAQC form for the zoning layer. In the next video, I will show you how to create and export a map.